It's the end of the week, and so it's time to take out the trash. For my garbage person of the week, I actually found it to be quite easy. If it's a very small petty thing, but I believe that as she so often does, Lauren Boebert deserves a position for this tweet. As allergy season gets underway, I encourage everyone to take their allergy medicines so that my allergy medicines can work. You know, it doesn't work unless everyone takes it. So if it's not clear the point that she's making, she still doesn't understand the difference between like an allergic response and a transmissible virus. She is a congresswoman. She's paid by us to litigate important issues and come up with legislation to address problems. She doesn't understand germs. Like, oh, I think everyone should put on their sunblock so that I won't get sunburned because it only works if everyone does. No, that's not the same thing, Congress Karen. You gotta pay attention. We've been trying to teach people about this science stuff for quite a while. How, like, if you wanna come out of the end of this pandemic and be like, you know what? I don't think COVID is that bad still. So I'm not wearing a mask. That's a political choice that I'm making. But to not understand what a germ is such a self-owned to tweet something like that. Adrienne, what do you think?
I think it's absolutely very reflective of who she is as a person. And I'm not particularly shocked at all. And I really actually think that Maverick has more intelligence than she does. And he agrees about her being a nonsense person. Say what's up.
That is a gorgeous cat, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
What a face. Well, that's my garbage person. These are our garbage people, but all of you chose one as well. 37,000 of you voted in our poll. And here are your top five for this week. Dick Durbin's in at 1% of the vote. I assume it's an insufficient defense of Ketanji Brown Jackson. I'm not sure because for the first time ever, the reasons aren't listed on here. Anyway. At number four, Marsha Blackburn at 8%, probably for her stuff about religion, her stuff about the definition of a woman, just terrible. Or her trying to get Ketanji Brown Jackson to deny structural racism. Anyway, number three at 11% of the vote, you have Josh Hawley for all of his QAnon signaling. Number two at 23% of the vote, you have Lindsey Graham for freaking out and walking out of the hearing because he didn't like the answers he was getting. But Ted Cruz is your community garbage person of the day with 57% of the vote for blowing up big photos of infants and talking about racist babies and being a racist baby and just being the worst. Anyway, thank you to the 37,000 of you who voted. For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.